Garrett, we asked the investment panel this question. I want to ask you this. We're at the top of the market. Well,
close.
Maybe.
For like, when is it going to stop? I've been saying the same thing.
We're in year 10 of a big boom.
Yeah.
What are you investing in right now, or what do you see coming? How are you managing your wealth differently, or is it the same path forward in these economic
times? A little
times?
Different. One is I am stuffing every dollar the government will allow me into my overfunded life insurance plan right now, because I want massive liquidity. I could pull that money out at any time. I'd have to do better than 9.9% to put it somewhere else, and that's a pretty amazing storage tank. And the second thing is, I started to look at investing not as products, but let me give this equation, and then I'll answer the second half. There's this equation. Who in here wants more money just by a show of hands here? Okay? All right, if you don't, earmuff this, okay? So financial capital is a byproduct. It's a byproduct. So if you think you have a money problem, you never have a money problem. It's actually a problem of two more precious forms of capital, one being called mental capital, which is your knowledge, your wisdom, your insight, your tools, your strategies, mental capital. If you've ever heard, it's not what you know, it's who you know. That's not true, because Ryan doesn't hang out with me, and I don't hang out with Ryan if neither of us brings anything to the table. We're just someone, we'd make fun of each other, essentially, right? So what you know matters in today's world. And the second piece is relationship capital, which are people, networks, organizations, mentors, family, friends. And if you want more financial capital, you're either an idea or a relationship away from that next level of prosperity. So I am bullish and aggressive on investing in quality relationships. I'm bullish on investing in the right mental capital and attending and spending time with the right people. I put a lot of money in that every year because it always pays off in a big way for me. So that never changes regardless of the economy. But I stopped looking at investments as products, and I started looking at investments as, what are my biggest skill sets? How can I package that up and start bringing that to the marketplace, not only to customers and clients, but even to other financial people? And in the last 2 years, by looking at that, half of my income comes from licensing what I do, and I consider that my number one investment. And I can get six-figure and seven-figure like payouts in short periods of time. I can't do that with any other investment, unless I would have gotten into crypto when I was first told about it.